Hello everyone and good afternoon sir. Today we have Mr. Professor Bhaskar Mitra who is basically NIFT and LCF NTU alumni and near about 30 years of experience with this industry of 15 years experience and in education with 15 years. So now currently he is working here as a campus director of Presidency University of School of Design. So sir, today we want to share really your experience and knowledge with the student, those are looking for a career in design. Mm-hmm. So first thing about Presidency, what you'd like to highlight about it?
Presidency is a brand and a goodwill in the market, which has been there for almost 50 years now. Mm-hmm. Currently will be 49 years we are going on. Yeah. And another 1 year will be doing the Golden Jubilee. Mm-hmm. So Presidency is a name at Bangalore and definitely India, and there is no other institute which has got such good reputations in terms of commitment, in terms of the kind of alumni that we have, because we start from school. So almost we have got 8 schools in Bangalore and one in Bangalore, and then we have got 3 colleges. And 2013 we came out with the university. So presently School of Design is evolved and we have started from 2019, and School of Design is really doing good.
Okay, so sir, can you highlight the courses that Presidency School of Design has?
Presidency School of Design, we have communication, which is one of the best design area where students are focused on upcoming. Then we talk about product design. Then we have fashion design, then space and interiors, and then we have game design, then multimedia.
Okay.
These are the areas.
So what are the duration of these all courses and what kind of degrees it has?
So we have 4 years of bachelor degree, leaving multimedia.
Okay.
Multimedia is only itself is 3 years degree.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how the curriculum has been designed now for all the courses, because academic is one of the major concern of the skill development in design.
Yeah.
So how's academy has been designed, sir?
So the mainly focused syllabus, first part is we have got the best faculties, which comes from premier institutions and also international faculties. So what we see that we are more collaborating way of industry. So the syllabus that are developed is based on what is the need of the industry.
Okay.
What is the current job profile that the students are looking for? Or what is the kind of package? Suppose a student is looking for at least an average package of 30,000 to 50,000. Almost 3.5 to 6 lakhs between. So based on that, how industry is going to accept them? And what are the areas they have to be skilled? So we definitely focused on experiential wing, more on hands-on working, more on the current technology and the kind of digital world that is focused. So we focus on the industry experts which guides us. So every semester we are having a board of studies. So there's a member, there's a committee which is coming from outside, from industry and academia both. And they support us in guiding us, advising us that what is right and how things should go every semester. What is the kind of upgradation we do? Almost 20% of the upgradation we do every semester for the entire syllabus of School of Design.
Okay, so how the student will get the industry exposure, like you were discussing about that, you have industry connect.
Yes.
So how they'll get, in which semester they are going to get into that industry exposure with the this design industry?
Okay, so what we see that we have got almost one semester that we send every student to the industry. That comes after the fifth semester. So when they go for a sixth semester, after the completion of sixth semester, there's a duration of 8 weeks industry internship during the summer term. But definitely the kind of exposure that we need for them to be in the industry is very less.
Okay.
So what we see from the second year onwards, they have got summer term. So definitely we have got a practice that every student should have at least completion of, for the first year, they have got a summer term. There they go for a craft documentation.
Okay.
For 2 weeks.
That's in
syllabus.
Syllabus, okay.
So they have to go to the field, understand the craft from any part of India, focus on it, and try to research on how things has been done by artisans in the village.
Okay.
And what is the kind of designs that they come out with without any education background.
Mm-hmm.
So now what our students are doing it, they're documenting the entire process of how rural level people are thinking about design.
Mm-hmm.
And how they're making a production and their livelihood.
Okay.
Next part is they document it and come back.
Mm.
Here we guide them that after documentation and research and understanding of a particular craft in India, how they are going to use that research work and come out with their own design, which will be more commercialized and can be sellable to the market, not just India but also international.
Okay.
Now this idea, we give it back to the villagers.
Good.
So that they understand that yes, something they have got from our students which is getting educated through design. So it's about earn while you learn. You take something from the rural areas, the villagers, the artisans, and then you give it back to them also.
Okay.
If they think that this idea is really good, they'll definitely execute it.
Mm.
And definitely we have got a startup incubation center here.
Okay.
So we also see that if any good ideas are coming from students in collaboration with any artisan or any craftsperson, we tend to fund minimum amount where they can start with a brand. And both artisan and students can start a brand in nature of collaboration. That can be a pilot project. And the incubation center, we have got a lot of good faculties who can nurture them, not in just terms of design, but we have got interdisciplinary approach like management who can understand how to manage a brand, how to manage the system. We have got law faculties who can tell them the legal aspect of design and the brand development. Then we have got engineering students who can talk about promotions, social media. Then we have got definitely the language schools, which can definitely think about content development and other things. So you can see the entire holistic approach of supporting a brand and nurturing a brand when a student would like to start from the second year itself.
Okay.
So this is about craft documentation in the 1 month's expertise that they do outside the campus.
Okay, sir, most of the students, like, they spend a lot of time in classroom also. So how the classroom has been designed here? Because that is a very important aspect here, because being into creative field that nowadays studio kind of setup, and how the classroom has been designed, sir?
So mainly 85% of the syllabus is skill based.
Okay.
That means lab based work.
Mm.
So we have got a classroom which is studio based, where maximum 25 to 30 students can have accommodated in a classroom. It's a studio based, so they have got all machinery, sitting arrangements, they have got systems, they have got big television screen, they have got internet connectivity, they have got all sort of facilities which is required for every discipline.
And do you have MATLAB also for
this? We have got MATLAB, we have got all sort of software which is required for digital tools and equipments, which is required for digital design like communication, multimedia, game design. So here we have got almost more than 20 different softwares to do designing. Which starts from Maya, which starts from Adobe Photoshop, the Adobe full area is there. We are looking for a lot of different softwares in gaming, a lot of different software for making 3D modeling, rendering, texturing. So these are useful for both multimedia, product design and gaming.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and we also get a lot of expertise from the industry, where they come and real-time exposure they get it from the industry people.
Okay, so they come to campus also for the classes?
They come to campus and we go for a sort of workshop mode.
Okay.
Where continuously they can go and come up with an output. So yesterday only we have completed one workshop from game design, where you take any photograph and you can render it and design it the way you want it. Suppose you want to make a design which looks 500 years old. So that rendering is going to help you to make a vintage look or a classic look or a retro look. Which gives you a feel and look of, yes, it is almost 500 to 1000 years old.
Okay.
So this is the specialization of that software.
Sir, the student has, like, most of the student they are coming from outside of Bangalore, they stay in a hostel. So what kind of facilities in terms of the lab, in terms of like coming to library is open for them? Till what time, because if they want to avail the services, till what time they can come and
See, here we have maximum 7 o'clock, 7 p.m. Okay. And after that, they go back to the hostel. The plus point is Bangalore is very high tech. So we have every resources which is digital library. So they can sit in the hostel and they can access the library through online.
Okay, so online access is there.
Online access is there.
For every student.
For every student. It's not that every book is there, but almost 30 to 40% of the books which they require is given through online.
So what kind of association we have with the like university which is that what kind of association with, can you name some of the universities that
so we have almost 100 plus associations with more than 40 countries and in design particularly we have got association with NAVA in Milan, we have got Nottingham Trent University, Birmingham City University, then we have got AI Win City in Paris which is only working on AI, so we are in dialogues with them. So most probably our focus would be more into AI, ChatGPT, digital communication design. So we are also in tie-up with a lot of game design US-based universities. We have got also in Asia specific, there are few universities that we can focus and they get a full scholarship to go to those areas. Full scholarship means this is one of the plus point that a student can go to any university that are partnered with us. They go for 2 weeks to 3 weeks for a summer vacation or a summer course. And there the fees is waived off.
Okay.
Only the to and fro and the what are the other apart from fees, other things has to be focused.
Okay.
And next is then also they also get a chance to go for a full semester, two years.
Okay. If they wish, they can.
If they wish. It all depends on the selection criteria.
Okay.
If the student is good, having a good portfolio, good presentation, and a vision to go outside. So even in Asian countries also, we send them out with a complete 2 years scholarship. Even they are paid for the hostel also. Fooding, lodging also they pay, apart from fees. And they don't have to pay anything to the university.
Okay. Sir, Bangalore is a city of startup because it is very famous for startup you can see that. Like how the design student, like creative student will get benefit of the city. Can you highlight some point on it?
Yes. So we have started with incubation startups. So we have got a PLA. Residency Startup Center. So what we see that we have got almost 50 startups which are associated with us. Within the students, outside also. So professional startups are also connected with us where they can get the right kind of support from mentoring, nurturing and funding. So we have got an exclusive team which helps us out to understand the idea, to have the legal process, to manage the entire thing, to register it, then to fund it also, if the idea is really good. And recently we have got four ideas, brilliant ideas, with the funding agencies who are ready to fund our students from School of Design. One is from Communication Design, who has got a great idea and he has already started with the plan. Then we talk about Game Design. So the student is from New Delhi. So his focus is to start his own brand on game because game is the future. And there they have got more than 10 million funding, what you call, proposals. That can be done.
Sir, generally guardian, most of the parents have one concern, they are coming from outside of Bangalore, that that whether the city is safe or not. So can you say something about it, that about Bangalore and about the location where this university, Presidency University, has the campus? So is it safe for the student or?
Yes. Bangalore Presidency is located everywhere in India, everywhere in Bangalore, sorry. But exclusively if I talk about the university, it is located near to the airport. So from our campus, the airport is just 25 to 30 minutes without any traffic. That's one of the best part. Next is, it is pollution free. If you go to the Bangalore city, compared to that city, chaotic city, we have a pollution free and a much relaxed area. And here the economical cost is there compared to the main city. And absolutely it is safe for girls and not for just girls. It is safe for everyone. Because what we see that in South India, it's not about, it's the kind of respect that we have, the kind of ethics the kind of social ethics that people have here is much, it's better that we see. It's all over India, but it's better here. And there's no issue of male, female or children or maybe anyone who is coming from any part of India. Bangalore is a hub where maximum people are coming for jobs, mainly for IT, design, technology, which is startups. But I don't find anything like that. It's much safe.
I can see, sir, a lot of students roaming here and there, yeah, campus. Absolutely. So, what is the total number of students, including all the courses that Presidency University has?
In last 9 years, we have almost 17,000 plus students across all disciplines.
Great.
And we have got a beautiful green lavish campus with beautiful infrastructure already you've seen. And it's an international standard that we would like to set up. And it has been done, and we are coming out with more infrastructure now. For School of Design also, we have got a beautiful infrastructure, but we are expecting a new building almost in coming 2 to 3 years time. And one of the best infrastructure that we would like to provide with the kind of fees that we charge is very nominal. And the hostel also, it also looks like a university. The hostel is beautiful.
Okay.
So with all sort of modern technology, washing machines, the gymnasium is there. Then you talk about cafeterias and all sort of facilities, medical, counselors, then all internet facilities, all sort of facilities.
Is it far from the city or it's...
No. It's the Presidency University.
Yes.
University is just from here. It is, the name of the place is Elanca. So Elanca main city, the town, which is a beautiful town, is hardly 15 minutes from here, 15 to 20 minutes.
Okay, sir, student, I think I can see the energy and the kind of student has here. So, if anyone wants to apply for the College of School of Design, Presidency University, if one has to apply, then what are the criteria for it? Can you give me idea so that those are looking for a city, Bangalore, and they are looking for beautiful campus, they can come and avail and they can qualify for the exam. So what are those criteria, sir?
So the main criteria is that they have to have a test that has, they have to give it. It's a general ability test.
Okay.
So you understand the things which is required for design. When we talk about the communication, the analytical skills, then the mathematics, a bit of mathematics, not just mathematics, a calculation. And general knowledges. And then we talk about creative ability test. They have to do something which has been given to them through their creative mindset. And they have to give an overall reflection on what they need to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
And if someone is looking for a career in design, sir, then what are the suggestions you want to give to them?
Career in design, that design is everywhere. Design is a lifestyle. So morning till evening, everywhere is design. But it's just that we need more specialized and skilled people in the industry who can have the knowledge of how to implement in through business. So India needs at least 10 lakh designers in a year. But somehow we produce only 1 lakh. So we need more design schools. And that's why Presidency is one of them to come out with an idea to support the population with best education, design education, with a very economical fees, and then all with all support, with best infrastructure, and definitely the quality education that we mainly focus.
Bangalore is a city of IT and industry, so there, which course of design has more popularity here in Bangalore if they want to get settled in future also? So what do you recommend them that they should go for? Which course in Bangalore that if they want to come for Presidency University School of Design?
Yeah, so Bangalore, by seeing the market of Bangalore, it's the most cosmopolitan and people are experimental. So people from all over India come to Bangalore to have a standard life, because in Bangalore we see the standard of life is very good. And when we talk about professional life and personal life, those are absolutely maintained here. And people do respect that. So what we see, that if you go see the trend says that more of communication design, more of digital design, we talk about animation, graphics, VFX, UX, UI. So all these designs are much in demand, not just in Bangalore, but entire globe. Because what we see today, our students are working with Mercedes-Benz, Lamborghini. So they are looking for communication designers. They're looking for designers who knows the software, who knows who has the eye to design and beauty.
Mm.
So they are dealing with clients who buys the expensive luxury cars,
mm.
and they want a beautiful presentation for them. So this is how they are looking for that, who is very good in photography.
Mm.
They can translate the entire concept through digital.
Mm.
Now we have got people who are from space and interiors.
Mm.
They create the entire apartment in 3D model.
Mm.
So when before you go for any design of any apartments or any villas, you tend to see the beautiful design in your laptop. And that's the kind of work that they do.
Mm.
Our multimedia students are creating 1 minute to 5 minute videos.
Mm.
The kind of awareness that is necessary in the society, like women empowerment,
mm.
child labor,
mm.
sustainability, climate change,
mm.
Then we talk about pollution free. All these are the basic awareness. Based on that, they are creating movies.
Mm.
And they're applying for different competitions so that they spread the awareness through their creative work, which is digital.
Mm.
And then we talk about, we are following the 17 SDG goals.
Mm.
So based on that, recently our students had the workshop of filmmaking,
mm.
where we have invited at least 5 people from the industry, film industry in Karnataka, where they have helped the students to understand how to make a script from there, how to edit a movie and finally produce a movie in the market.
Okay.
And they have gone to the slums, they have gone to different areas, rural areas, they have dealt with villagers, they have dealt with people where they would like to showcase the real cause which is there through the kind of movies that they want. And it is all possible when you, today it's about digital. And if I want to connect the world, it's just one video, one click. If I upload in YouTube, the entire world gets to see it. That's the power of digital.
Okay.
And for that, we don't need crores of fund. It's just your mind and the kind of platform that we try to give it to you. And the kind of people that we have from the industry. It's not just faculty who are PhDs or qualified from other premier institutions, but also who are very, very old in the industry, 20, 30 years experience people who knows the technical part of it, who knows how to sell a product. Those people are also associated with us as guests or adjunct faculties.
Okay, okay. Sir, generally if, because Bangalore, mostly South India, like that student, they are coming here, then they do, North Indian, Akaskar, North Indian, they are having a problem of food. So, how's the food and how's the canteen food here? It's South Indian kind of dishes or North Indian dishes are
no,
also
the
there?
No, the people who are running the canteen is from North India only.
Okay.
So, and the cooks and all are maximum are from North India or maybe...
So, that's not a challenge for them.
That's not a challenge and I'm from also North India. So,
okay.
I don't find any difference here. It's how you manage your life. Everything is available. Bangalore is a place where you have a lot of varieties of food. Both South Indian, North Indian and cuisines all over the globe. So a lot of international people are also staying here from different countries.
Okay. So how like non-veg is here or not?
Absolutely. It's not about only veg or non-veg. All cuisines are there. All sort of foods are there. And people enjoy food here. So we are not restricted to any particular...
So do you have a scholarship provision also for the deserving candidates?
Yes. So we have scholarship programs and the scholarship programs, we can always share the schemes. We have got 40,000, 30,000, 20,000 scholarships that we pay.
And what is the criteria to get that, I mean, that scholarship?
Criteria is people who are applying for UCET and NIFT.
Okay.
And there's a specific rank that we have to see.
Mm.
Based on the ranking, they get the...
Is there any portfolio route also for interview during selection process?
So we do talk to students online, digital, and understand their mindset on why they would like to come for design. Because portfolio, you can get it done from anyone. But when you speak about your portfolio, that gives you the right picture whether that student is fit for design or not. Because they have to express their portfolio. So this is what we do online, that half an hour interviews there, 20 minutes to half an hour, to understand the student through their portfolio, what they have made and how far they would like to go and what is their vision and what they would like to become in future.
And what are the skills required to be a good designer, sir? That one has to...
The kind of skill set that is required is we are providing. Mainly we are looking for students who are mentally very strong and they have got a clear vision that yes, this is what I have to do. The main thing that industry is looking for is first is the commitment with yourself. If you are committed to yourself, we can do anything. Then you have got a passion, a dream. What is your dream? If you don't have a dream, whatever skills you know, it's of no use. So you have to, first of all, you have to come with a dream. And that dream, we would like to make sure that how much we support you to make your dream successful. The kind of skills that we want, that yes, if today people are very strong in digital, they are already in Facebook, social medias, they know how to edit their photographs. They should be very smart. Today it's not about just hard working, it should be a smart work also. They should be familiar with gadgets like mobile phones, technologies, they are okay familiar with laptops, if not all different softwares. If a student is not at all good in sketching, doesn't matter at all, because we are not selling a sketching. The sketching is part of a brainstorming which comes from your mind to a paper. And if you're not good in expressing that on paper through your sketch, you can apply through a story also, writing a story. You can also apply through making a movie. You can apply through a digital software that you're familiar with. So earlier in our times, it was that if you're good in sketching, only then you can go for design. Today the concept is entirely different because everything is digital. So people who are tech savvy, more digital oriented, and who has the command of awareness of market, that yes, this is what is happening, and they can, the openness is there.
Generally, there is a myth that if one is from PCM or PCB, PCM they go for engineering, they go for biology. Generally, what I also see that if any, they see that if I'm from science background, then I'll go for engineering or medical. So what are like humanities people, they come for the design. So do you really believe, sir, what they should opt in their class 12 if one has a very good analytical skills, if they are from PCM background? So does it help them in future designing the things?
See, today we have almost a collaboration with Dundee, one of the university from Scotland. So the person came with a beautiful idea that why not Presidency University, we collaborate with them for medical design. Business design. So I've asked them that what is medical design? Is it necessary that they have to be from that background? So they have said it's not about, nothing to do with science background. Anyone who has intelligence, who has the smartness of understanding the market and fulfill the demand of medical industry, they are looking for medical design. So it's more about understanding the industry. As a designer, how I connect my ideas with the kind of products which is required in the medical industry, and based on that I'll create those and supply it to the industry. It's a big industry which is coming up, because today also there are few students who are doing a lot of research on medical costumes. Today you go to any hospitals in India, there are a lot of dialysis which is done on liver, lungs. There are a lot of different things, and they don't have a particular uniform for that. There's just an apron where they put it up, and the lift kit which is not comfortable for a lot of patients. So there are a lot of costumes, there are a lot of garments, there are a lot of products which is created for analyzing the issues which is there for patients, and based on that they start creating it. Then we talk about design in business. For everything you need design. That's why this design thinking subject is there in management, engineering. So to create a city also, you need design thinking.
Okay.
To create a kitchen also, you need design.
So, taking any particular subject, anyone can come.
Anyone. Design is very, design is...
Has science also.
Design is science only. Okay. Because we are talking about today, the design is all about problem solving design.
Okay.
Not a piece of soap or a soap piece that we just exhibit and people would buy. That is the work of an artist. But design is solving the purpose of a problem which is existing in the society.
It means technology and design are working together.
Technology, design and innovation. These are the three things.
Okay.
Without innovation, for example, Tesla car. So you talk about Tesla car. So why this Tesla has come? Because the natural resources are getting finished. Someone has thought of, Elon Musk has thought of using electricity or some sort of energy which will run the entire automobile through energy. And today he is famous, he is one of the richest person. Why? Because of the idea only. People have got a lot of money. People could have done that. But he has got the copyright of the idea. And no one can duplicate it.
Okay.
So we are talking about generating ideas through design thinking. Any segment of this globe where we would like to pitch in and license or copyright our ideas. And people are there to invest on such ideas. That's why this incubation center is there in our university. People are sitting there with money, but they don't have good ideas. That's the biggest challenge in India, or maybe the globe, because we are too, why this is happening, there's a reason. We are too much connected with digital world, Google and other platforms. If you need anything, you click it and you get it. If you start using your brain, that is a supercomputer, which is created by the superpower. It is never ending. If you start using it and if you create designs, I'm very sure that you will be one of the best designers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, great sir. It was lovely talking to you. And
thank you.
And it was thanks for your time and thanks for your so much idea how this industry is running and what this college is, what are the courses offering. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.